In today's video, you can go through the organization of chemical engineering project and the role of chemical engineering in all stages of that. Indeed, chemical engineering projects are divided into four types, depending on the novelty involved. First type is development of new plants that are conducted by EPCM companies. The new plant development process is called greenfield project. Then amendment and extension of existing plant that are generally implemented by the plant design group and called as brownfield projects. The third type of chemical engineering project is production scale-up or debottlenecking to match the sales demand. And finally, development of new processes from laboratory research or through the pilot plants to a commercial process. The chemical engineering projects are developed by following some phases. It starts with front-end engineering design, which is the stage of development of process modeling drawing, such as block flow and process flow diagrams in simulators and initial estimation of construction cost. Then, detailed engineering design is followed to prepare information packages that describe the plant in sufficient detail for construction to begin. Later, in construction phase, equipment installation and piping are completed and ready to be tested in commissioning phase. This phase is to ensure that the systems are designed, installed, tested, and maintained. If all phases are completed appropriately, then the final stage of the startup is carried out to begin the operation with their main fleets. You became aware of the types of engineering projects and their organization phases, but what about the role of chemical or process engineers in this workflow? Indeed, process engineer plays an important role throughout the all stages of the project. As a process engineer, you're responsible for developing process flow diagrams, heat and material balance of the plant by utilizing the process simulation software, performing sizing of the equipment as per required process duty, developing process data sheets of the equipment, writing basis of design, operating philosophy, and system operating guidelines, and transferring the process flow diagrams into the piping and instrumentation diagram, and finally, developing process cause and effect diagrams.